Hi folks, this is Melvin from OptoProductions.com with another VCV Rec tutorial. This time, I'll show you how to make a kick drum patch from scratch. Alright, so first of all, we need a sound source, so let's grab a VCO. Now we need to modulate the volume of this VCO by adding a VCA and an ADSR envelope. Let's patch the sine output to the VCA input and the output of the VCA to the audio module. And for the CV input, we'll use the envelope output. Okay, so we still need a way to trigger the envelope. We can use an LFO for that. If we take the square output from the LFO, we can send it to the gate input of the ADSR envelope. It basically functions like a trigger. You can clearly see this if I add a scope module. You can change the length of the trigger by adjusting the pulse width knob. Let's change the ADSR envelope a little bit. So we have no attack, no sustain, a little bit of release, and a long decay. Let's also turn down the frequency of the VCO. Speed up the frequency of the LFO a little bit. Now a real kick drum changes in pitch from high to low when it decays over time. We can simulate this by adding another ADSR module and by sending its output to the FM input of the VCO. I'm using the FM input and not the voltage per octave input, because we can control the modulation amount with the knob above. And of course we also need to trigger it. Play around with the decay time a little bit and also with the FM amount. You may need to turn down the frequency of the VCO a little bit. And turn up the release to get rid of the click at the end. Instead of a sine wave, we can also use a triangle wave to add more harmonics. But maybe this is a bit too much. Let's insert a filter to tone it down a bit. Now we can also use the drive knob to add some distortion. We can even send the output of the first ADSR envelope to the filter cutoff as well. And play around with the CV amount. We can add some character to the sound by using the noise module. We'll need to shape the volume level of the noise with a VCA and an ADSR envelope. So let's take the white noise output and send it to the VCA input, and the envelope output we'll send to the VCA CV input. And now all we need to do is combine the two signals. So we need a mixer. Send output to channel 2. And the output of the sine wave or triangle wave to input 1. And we need a trigger, of course. You can make it really short to add a click, but you can also add some decay and attack. And turn down the level a little bit. To give it some character. And of course you can experiment with different types of noise, like pink noise. But I like red noise the most. It's subtle, but it adds a lot of character to the sound. You can make the sound more complex by adding another VCO, VCA and ADSR envelope. Let's do that. VCO. VCA. ADSR. So this time we'll take the sine wave output. And we need to send it a trigger. And let's send the output of the VCA to the mixer. Let's mute this one for now. And of course, we can also modulate the pitch of this VCO as well. Let's add another ADSR envelope. Because hey, we're using software after all. So there's no limit to how many modules we can use. Let's send it a gate. And let's send the envelope output to the FM input. So now we can create a click, for example. Awesome! That's a great kick right there. Okay, that's it for this video. You can clearly see the power of modular synthesis. Especially with VCVREC, you have no limits on how many VCAs, envelopes or LFOs you can add. The possibilities really are endless. Let me know if you have any questions or suggestions for future videos. And I'll see you in my next VCVREC tutorial.